Hello everyone and welcome to a tutorial on RPG developer Bakin. Today I'm going to show you how to make the base of a action battle system. This is kind of derived from a battle system Sana made. I will link his YouTube video in the description below. We need to make a couple variables. This is going to be a probably about a 2 to 3 part series. I'll show you how to do basic things. I'll show you how to make a couple actions, attacks and such, and enemies. I'll show you how to do pulling from the database and as well as making your own stats and such. Nothing too fancy. Enough to make it so where you can handle it yourself for sure. Actually, we don't even need this. My bad. All right, we actually need to do it this way. All right, so when it comes to Bakin, it's better to have, or when it comes to making any sort of event, you want to have an initialize event. It makes it run a lot easier. Everything just seems to process a lot easier. So, off. So when B button press, this is checking if the B button is being pressed. We're going to do a check variable bots. B button is equal to 2, which means it's being pressed. And then we are going to turn on a switch and we're going to call it attack pressed. Turn that on, and that's all that is going to do here. We'll make sure that our initialize flag is on, and we'll make sure that our attack press is on, but we'll make sure it's off. My bad, sorry. So what this page condition is doing is making sure that this page will run only if the attack press flag is off and the initialize flag is on. So starting from here, the initialize flag is off. This is starting the whole page. And we need to make sure this is always running because this is going to be looping. Whenever we press the B button, it's going to turn this flag on. On the next page, come on. Because Bakin's priority right here, sheet list is lower priority. So we're always going to start at 3, 2, and then 1. There. Which you'll see how that works later with an enemy. So this is going to be attack pressed. So with this, pretty much going to be like the same thing, but we're going to have attack presses on because we just pressed the B button, so the attack press button will be on now. And we're going to have the initialize is on as well. So here, but this is only going to be automatically start only once in parallel. So we need to stop our player operation because we don't want them to move. And then you can also get a little finicky. Your animations can kind of clip a little bit and whatnot. Party. Orientation, disable. Now here, depending on if you are using 3D or 2D is where things can get kind of a little finicky. With this, if you're using 3D, you have to make it, it gets actually super finicky because the animations don't always line up properly. So with 2D, it's a lot easier because it's just a 2D animation. Oh, where is it? Where is it? Oh, 2D casts, hero casts. Oh wait, come on, where are you? I hear it. No, come on now. So we'll just do. We'll do that. That's fine. We need to have it to where this is kind of like an attack buffer. There. And then right after we're going to do the actual attack. That was what? 4 or something or 3? Excuse me. This one. Play the whole motion. We'll put a sound effect in here too. Too much. where is it? Play as 3D sound because it's. We'll crank that down quite a bit. Okay. I'll turn up the tempo. Okay, that's fine. Alright, there. And then we'll leave that blank for now because we're going to have to be generating an event to show as our hitbox. So there, and then we need to have a wait of about 2 seconds, and then we're just going to copy these two right here, and then turn off the flag. I'm just going to show you what's going to happen whenever we do this right now. So if we save. Oops, sorry, there we go. I had to switch over real quick. And do here. Come into here and I press F. Oh, over here, press F5. You'll see where it says B button. Oh, actually, it messed up. I gotta come back to here. Oh, I need to. Oh, this is nothing, anyways. Delete that. We'll call this basic attack. Once. we didn't add the most important part. So we need to set bbuttons operation key to action key 2. So that's the most important part. You need to make sure you set the action key to operation key to action 2. Okay, so we're gonna test this out again. Come here, new game, and then see, you can see button 2 is being pressed, at we are attacking is pressed, and it's turning off. All right, awesome. The next step. Nope, casts. We need to make a hitbox. So we're going to call this P. We'll call it basic attack. Attack. All right. And from here, we need to change a bit of the parameters up top. So you turn off no damage, generate an error, generate in priority, and then you're going to change the elapsed time to 0.1. You'll go to custom event settings. We need to do a parallel sheet. Well, we'll need two parallel sheets. So this first parallel sheet is going to be our initialize event again. And this is going to be whenever it generates. So same process again, switch, made another local variable, initialize, off, turn it on. Like I said, this just makes everything run a lot smoother. It's just so things aren't stacking on top of each other all at once, and the program can run things a lot smoother. All right, and this is going to be hit detect. Okay, hello. Detect. This is going to be a parallel. So this is going to be a check collision state, and this is going to be this event for event. And we're going to obtain name of check destination chat 1, and we're going to name this P target, which is going to be player target. Okay. And when that happens, we're going to delete it. All right. And then up here, we are going to have a custom collision range. We don't need it colliding with the player. We only need it colliding with other events. This can be up to you. It doesn't really matter size-wise, as long as it's not bigger than the box. It's up for the basic attack. Eventually, you'll have it depending on the kind of attacks you'll have. So like if you have a full map attack, it'll be as big as your collision box. But we'll get into that possibly, maybe not. I might let you experiment, kind of figure out on your own. But we'll make it kind of just like a wall. Nothing too fancy. That's fine. You don't need to change anything here, but all we need to do is automatically start only once. And super, super simple. We're going to go events, event walk, walk in direction facing. We're going to pass through players slash events. We don't need to ignore elevation. You abort if unable to move is you can leave unchecked. I don't remember properly. And it's about 3 steps is I think as far as you need to go. And that's about it for the movement. So we'll do movement there, and then we can even test it right now. So you'll go back to your common events, basic attack, right here where it says the wait 2 seconds. You'll go to control, generate events, shooting source is the player. So it's going to be event to be generated. It's going to be basic attack. It's going to be direction where which generating source is facing to 180 degrees. Wait until shooting is complete. Apply. Save again. You always save after you do anything before you test play because you never know what's going to happen. And when we press options, view collision, show all, you'll see that it pops right there. So we can adjust it just a little bit because we want it to kind of go about to right here. We want it to kind of be about the edge of the knife. So let's go ahead and tweak it just a little bit. So we'll make it about 5. I think that should be good. So going back to here. Okay, you know what I think it is? It's not even that. It's tweaking this, I forgot. So 0.12, maybe that should be okay. It's not even the steps, it's all right, show all. Yeah, that's fine. So going back to here, don't even worry about the steps, just make it like 2 steps. That's fine, because it's not gonna even make that whole steps. Okay. So let's go ahead and make a enemy real quick. So add 2D stamps. I already made a little, have an elf right here guy. We will call him enemy. Okay, let's try it again. Enemy. Custom event settings. Same thing again. We're gonna make an initialize. This is gonna set up their collisions. Actually, before we do that, you're gonna wanna go over to here. Since it's a 2D stamp, make their collisions accurate, because when it comes to 2D stamps, just make all their collisions accurate. Don't even worry about their physics settings, because it just makes it, your life a lot easier. All right, so going back to here, enemy, custom event, this, make it about the size of their stamp, but not too small, not too big. Yeah, that should be okay. All right, so we want them to collide with other events, other player, the player. That's fine. All right, so automatically start at once. Check event switch. Same thing again. We're gonna need to make a couple other variables and switches as well. So we're gonna go ahead and do that now. So we're going to make our HP. We need to make an initialize switch. We need to make a dead switch. We need to make coordinate X, coordinate Y. We need to make distance X, player X, distance Z, player Z. Oh, not Y. I think that's it. HP and Z, that's it. Yeah, okay. So initialize when that's off. We'll go ahead and set all this up. So here, we're just gonna set the HP real quick. We'll make it like, I don't know, we'll make it like 80 or something. That's fine. and then we'll turn the switch off. This is just setting up. This is where you'll set up like their stats and attack values and everything. Switch. No. Come on, switch. Turn off. Initialize. On. Come on. There we go. All right, when this is off. And when dead is off. Is off. Perfect. This is just saying that when it's not dead and when this is not on. Perfect. All right, make another one. Swap it there. This is going to be the hit detect. Make another one. This is going to be dead. Make it. Oh, no. Delete you. Yes. This is going to be your coordinates. Coordinates. All right. So here, no, coordinates x is going to be this event, x coordinate. This is important because it's going to get, it's going to be for our force to hit the enemy. And also, it'll be important in the future later, too. Control, I like to use this to put as a break in between. So actually we need to go out here real quick and make player coordinates. No, not battle. So we need to get the player coordinates real quick. Because we'll need to have a distance check between them, so may as well get that real quick. Player board X. Player board Z. Alright, so very quick. X. Player X. And said, perfect. Player chords. All right, awesome. All right, let's go back into the database. That's a good thing about when you're working with an event or in the database, you can just go right back into your event. Don't have to worry about placing it on the map because it's in your database. All right, so back to here, hit detect. This is going to be repeat and parallel, because we need to always be checking it. Super easy. We need to have a condition judgment. Check collision state. When this event and another event, we're going to be checking the player target. And then we're going to check a string. And then when player target is basic attack. So, cool thing about the string checking. Oop. So, whatever your, well, we gotta change it to that exact value, but whatever you're generating is gonna be how the collision works. So, because it's an event and the name is this exact name, it'll only be checking the collision for this exact name. So, because the exact name is basic attack, it'll only be colliding with that exact name. So like, it doesn't matter if it's running into other events, it won't work unless it's running or being colliding with that exact name. All right, perfect. So we're going to, no, not yet. Favorite bots. Local variable HP. Oh, actually, hang on. We're gonna go back to coordinates because we didn't finish that up. All right, real quick. So distance x to player x, this is going to be, we have to assign it to player or coordinate x real quick. Same for z, because we need to get the distance. Okay, then another quick note, because we like to break it up. All right, now we need to get the vector distance between this current event and the player. So we will do this, which is and then subtraction. Oh, no, other way around, sorry. Distance. That's right, so we're looking from the event to the player. That's right. Yes, okay. And same for the Z. Okay, nope, Z. There we go. All right. So that'll work there. All right, back to here. So we're going to subtract the HP. We'll just do a random number right now. We'll do 3 to, like, say 8. That's fine. And then subtract. Eventually, this is where you'll do your damage calculations. You'll have to do your own because we can't physically take the damage formula from the Bakin battle system. Right now, anyways. I think eventually, maybe in the future, we'll be able to. But right now, you could technically use a C script. It would go down here and whatnot, or somewhere else in the system. You can use that. I have tested that in the past. But I'll get into that maybe in the future if this expands and whatnot. But I digress. Let's keep going. I'm almost like 30 minutes into this video. Let's keep going. We will go to display effect on this event. Effect. I need a particle. Where is it? I think it was hard. I will do slash one, but I'm gonna take away that sound because I already have that sound. I'll get back to that in a minute. Okay. So there. And then we need to do a little bit of where is it? Here. Variable. So we're gonna go back to this value right here. We're gonna change to about 50 multiplication. So this is gonna be setting the force of how we're gonna be moving around the enemy to kind of give it a little bit of like push and pull as we're hitting it. Let's see. And now this is actually kind of really, really cool. So the higher this is, the harder it'll fall down. So like if this is super low, it'll kind of just like float off into the air. So like I'll set it to about like 41. That should be good. But not yet. So here and then event. Event physics, we'll set the variables to our distance x. We'll set this to about, I'd say about 80. Give it a little pop up. And then the z to this. All right. So yeah, so we're multiplying the distance between the player, the event x to the player X, and that's gonna, we're gonna multiply that by 50. That'll give us the force to move it left and right, and then the Y, same thing. So this will move that around when we hit it, just a smidge. It won't do too much. It's not gonna be like substantial, but it'll give us that nice little effect. And we'll pop it up a little bit too. And then here, So here we should do it actually down here. And move that here and then start having. So check once the HP, no, not delete, excuse you. HP is less than or equal to zero. Then we're going to do this. We're gonna make the four super hard. We'll do the force to like 250. And we'll like slam it in the ground. So we'll do like 141. And then do like 180. We'll send it flying. And then you'll turn on your switch. Your dead switch. Turn that on. And then what that does, it means that we're gonna go over here, but we need to turn on some flags. So we make sure the dead flag is off. We need to make sure that the initialize flag is on. So back to your dead switch. This, you don't need a custom collide range. Well, just make it small. It doesn't have to be anything. You don't need it colliding with anything because it's dead. You can have it repeat. That's fine. Because we're going to do a little trick. We also got to do something too. I forgot to add. Dead is on because it is dead because we are on the dead page. Initialize is on. And I forgot to add this too. We also want to have a little the damage effects. There we go. All right. So dead. There, emotion, it is dead. All right, so let's play it. Not emoticon. Effect, we're just gonna use the simple bait, or the simple already defeat effect, because I don't really have anything else to use, and that's easy. Done. Then we're going to do a look. This is a, you won't technically leave it like this. But when you're testing and you want to like just keep killing stuff just for testing purposes and everything, you'll turn these on to pretty much keep them alive forever. And we gotta go back and add this too. Let's see, control, weight, like 1.2. But yeah, all right, so there. So initialize, we gotta make it visible too because it'll come back. All right, make it fit visible. All right, so the enemy should be ready. Now let me just go into the particles real quick to turn off that sound and the shake. Oh no, none. All right, so the sound should just be in the attack, so that's perfect. All right, so there. And we should be good after this, I think. Oh, well, has to be on the map, that would help. All right, let me put one down and then we will test with multiple. So we're gonna put one down, save it, and let's see how it runs. Yep, see, he kind of slides around. Well, okay, slides around a little too much. Oh. Well, no, that should be right. Well, the jump I don't need. Damn it, I need to turn down a little bit too. That's funny though. But yeah, that's kind of like an idea. I think I do need to turn down. But yeah. Yeah, you gotta turn down the values quite a bit. Oh yeah, 50 is way too high. I forgot about that. It's like 10. And this can only be like 30 or something. All right, let's try that again. No. All right. Yep, cool. Bye! Although I am a little curious, something might not be working correctly. Alright. Well, let me flatten this map out real quick, because it's a little too busy. Yeah, it's a little too busy. Put a bunch around. Well, that's a hang on. Let me. Let me kind of have them wander around while I'm doing hit detect. Random movement frequency lowest, speed the slowest. Okay, and then again a bunch. Okay, and then go back to game definition. Yeah, I think the map was just a little too high. All right, let's try this again. And I think we should be ready to end it. Yep, perfect. Yeah. Yeah, you'll see how they get back up because, because they die. But they come back to life because of the flag. But yeah, alright guys, thanks for watching, and in the next part we'll do a little bit more tweaking, get the collision or the gravity working a little bit better. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.